Very pleased to be joined by the head coach of the Hoosiers, Tom Allen. Coach, you and I were talking at practice today, and, you know, 2 straight 5-7 seasons, but so close, so many close games against really good teams. And I know kind of the question for you now heading into this year is, what do you have to do to get over that hump?
Yeah, it's my voice is a little shot, but, you know, it's just a common question that we get asked, and we talk about it as a team. You know, it's pretty well documented. And as you said, it's you know, sometimes you feel like you're close in certain situations, but it's the evidence is there. It's in the last 2 seasons alone, 7 games and 1 possession or less, and being put in those positions. And so to me, the answer is this. It's believing in what we're doing. Stay with the plan. And that's recruiting the best players we can find that fit our system, developing those players once we get them here, and then creating confidence in that weight room and our player development piece, and then not let that transfer to the field as you grow in your maturity, you grow in your talent, you grow in your depth to allow you in those critical situations, those 3rd and 7s in the fourth quarter when you got to make a big play, get the stop on defense, make the competitive catch, and get the first down on offense, you know, create that key special teams play, whatever that may be. And then once you have those opportunities and you are making those in the games, then it creates confidence and it builds off each other. So there's no real secret formula to it, but to me, it's about staying the course and believing what you're doing.
You did make a change, new defensive coordinator in Kane Womack. You have been the defensive coordinator for the first couple of years. What do you like most about how that transition has worked?
Well, it's been pretty smooth, and I think, first of all, because, you know, Kane was here a year ago, and he and I have been connected for so long to where we're on the same page philosophically, so there wasn't a change in scheme. But for me, the best part of it is it allows me to be a better head coach of the team, and I feel like I'm more connected with the other two units, special teams, especially offensively, and that to me is a big deal. You know, even in our team meetings, the time to prepare for those and put my focus and energy in that, to as I talk to our team about, you know, coaching their minds each night here during fall camp and how that looks, and to be able to have a better plan for that and to be able to do a better job of that. And then being more in tune with the offense. I'm sitting in all the pre-practice meetings on offense. I sat in the post-practice meetings on defense, and then get in all the special teams meetings. And so it allows me to be connected where in the past hasn't been the case. And so I think it's really allows me to do a better job of being both having the pulse of the team and know how to adjust the areas and increase the intensity of offense and special teams with my personality and the way I want things done.
And how will that help you make a decision on the quarterback, and how are those guys doing, and where are you with the decision?
Well, I think it helps just because I'm more familiar, you know, and at the end of the day, I got to make that final call, you know, and so obviously, you know, looking for the input of our offensive coaches and Kalen DeBoer, who both coaches the quarterbacks and coordinates the offense. But I'm in all those meetings, and I'm watching the film and breaking it down, and we have daily stats that we go through for each guy. And but at the end of the day, you just got to go with your gut with who the guy is that can best lead your team. You know, but I do think by being more involved and being more aware, that will help me make a better decision.
Is that a decision you'll make early, or will it get closer to the season, or
you want you got to know before the week before the first game. And like I've said all along, you know, Peyton's a returning starter, and he's the guy that they're going to have to beat out, you know, both Jack and Mike. And so, but to me, it's we're competing. We really are. And we put that out there, and I'm not ashamed to say that, and want them all to feel that. And I really want all positions to feel that way. But that's the position everybody talks about, because it's the position that really, runs your offense, runs your team. And so to me, we'll know. And when we know, we'll make the decision. But, you know, it won't go past by the time we get to the week before our first game, we'll make a decision.
Give us a feel for the line of scrimmage, offense and defensive line, after spring practice and after 3 or 4 practices so far.
Yeah, I've seen growth, especially on our offensive line from spring to fall. You know, I think Caleb Jones has really developed and worked extremely hard, changed his body, and much more confident. You know, Matthew Bedford's a true freshman, was here in the spring, but also is a guy that creates more depth for us. And just, Coy Cronk's just such a great leader. You know, he cares so much. Indiana kid, 4-year starter, big, strong, tough, mean. You know, but he cares, you know, and I just really appreciate him. And so he and Simon and Hunter, the 3 seniors, have really taken over that group. And I think that it shows. And then defensively, it's just a lot of guys that got to come along, you know, and they've worked extremely hard. And we've got stronger, we're heavier, we're more powerful on both sides of the ball than we were last year. But I think the technical part from the defensive line just will come.
Who might be your best pass rusher so far on defense?
Well, right now, if I had to just look at it, you know, Alan Stallings has been our number one guy. He's out right now with an injury that he'll recover from and be full speed. But the next guy to me, James Head, flashes. He's able to make some plays. He's going to be a true sophomore that played last year as a true freshman, and he flashes of being that guy. You know, Mike Ziemba's got some of the best speed we have on the defensive line, and so those two guys kind of pop out to me.
On the offensive side, you look at their backfield. You got some talented young men.
Well, I'm smiling. I mean,
you're both smiling.
That's right. Yeah.
I mean, that's a
just
good
hanging out with us that was making you smile.
Group of guys, how have they developed in, from a leadership standpoint as well?
Well, first of all, in the leadership council that we established, Stevie Scott was on that council, voted by his teammates. And even though he was the true freshman last year and had a breakout season, it has not affected him in a negative way. And we've challenged him about that. And he's taken it, and his body is in better shape than it's ever been. He looks really good.
First guy off the bus kind of
guy.
There's
no question. But his work ethic is the reason for that, But I tell you, competition does that to you. I mean, you look over his shoulder and there's guys behind him that won his job, but they're all going to play, And I love Mike Hart does a phenomenal job of teaching that, balancing that. Last night, our team meeting was about selflessness, being able to be a selfless team. And I talked about our running back room. There's only one football, but they all got roles to play, and they've got to be a complete back. That's pass pro, catching out of the backfield, understanding your role. Cole Guest has great burst, and he hurt us last year not having him when he went down the first game. But, there's several guys, Ronnie Walker, Samson James, and they've worked hard. They're strong, they're fast, and it's a good group.
Philosophically, how does the offense you're going to run here with Kalen DeBoer, first-year coordinator, compare to what you had been doing?
Well, there's some similarities. I mean, we're still, zone is zone, and power is power, counter is counter. But it's how we look doing it to me, the way it's presented, the personnel groupings. And we're obviously in install mode right now. But just the overall big picture of it, it's going to be different, And I'm not going to say too much. I'll be exposed on game day.
But ask, right?
Yeah, you do. And many have. And, yes. And I give a similar response. And so, but there is definitely, it's going to be different.
All right, Tom Allen, head coach of the Hoosiers. Always a pleasure, Coach. Thanks
so
much.
Appreciate it. LEO.